Dear colleagues, friends, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to the opening ceremony of the ICASP 2016. My name is Tom Law, a conference general co-chair, and I'll be the host of this ceremony today. So before we get to the speeches, let me first introduce the guests sitting on the stage, Professor Wenjun Zhang, conference general co-chair, Professor Barry Shoup, the president of IEEE, Professor Jose Mura, chair of the awards board of Signal Processing Society, and Professor Rabab Ward, the president of the Signal Processing Society. So the first speaker of this today's ceremony is Professor Zhi Ding, conference general co-chair, and he's going to give a few welcoming remarks on behalf of the organizing committee. Professor Ding.
Thank you, Tom. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends and colleagues. Welcome. Huan Ying. It is our distinct pleasure and privilege to start today's opening ceremony on behalf of the Organizing Committee of ICAST 2016 and the IEEE Signal Processing Society. We welcome you to the 41st IEEE International Conference on Acoustics, Speech, and Signal Processing. Signal processing has always been at the heart of the information technology and will continue to be the heartbeat of a smart society. Shanghai, situated in the center of China's signal processing hubs, is a perfect site to host the first ICASP in mainland China. We hope that the latest R&D results presented at this conference contribute to a strong foundation leading to the development of next generation technologies for a better and brighter future. With the help of our colleagues, the organizing committee has put together a very exciting program at ICAPS 2016. In addition to the traditionally strong program of technical papers, we are pleased to present five world-renowned plenary speakers. ICAPS 2016 brought together a school of highly anticipated tutorials on contemporary themes and topics. And the show and tell sessions continue the fine IEEE tradition of real-time experience by delegates on the latest signal processing advances. For the future of ICASP, SPS, and IEEE, we organized several student-oriented activities, including Best Student Paper Awards, Student Dialogue Session, and Student Luncheon. IEEE 2016 and student-related activities have received tremendously strong financial support from our industrial sponsors, and we are particularly thankful for their generosity. Please visit our sponsors and exhibitors booth in the Mandarin Hall on the first floor, where you'll find the latest signal processing tools, products, and surprises. Shanghai is the most populous city in China and the country's financial center. Shanghai has always been the locomotive of China's modernization for the past 200 years. A city with a rich and diverse heritage, Shanghai is proud to be the first in mainland China to host ICASP. And we encourage all of you to take a moment during the conference to experience and explore this very vibrant and unique city. We'd like to thank all our attendees and guests for joining us. We thank the city of Shanghai and its people for hosting ICASP. We thank our authors, session chairs, TPCs, TCs for the splendid technical contribution. And we thank the Signal Processing Society leadership, colleagues, volunteers, and staff members for the support. And we thank members of the organizing committee and the professional member of CMS and CFAO, without whom the conference would not be possible. And we're grateful to the incredible support from the sponsors and exhibitors. We are grateful to their generosity. We especially would like to thank the local team, many of them from Shanghai Jiao Tong University, and the team of student volunteers who are going to be instrumental throughout the conference. The staff members, the student volunteers, and the organizing committees shall continue to serve our delegates throughout the conference period. Thank you. 谢谢.
Thank you, Professor Ding. So as we know, at the heart of each year's ICAS is its technical program. This year's ICAS Technical Program Committee is co-chaired by Professor Dominic Ho and Professor PC Chen. Now let's welcome them on the stage to give some highlights of this year's ICAS Technical Program. Professor Chen.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, a very warm welcome to all of you. I was technical program co-chair for ICAS 2003, which many of you, those who are not too young, probably still remember that the physical meeting in Hong Kong was canceled in the last minute due to the outbreak of the SARS epidemic. I'm privileged to have the opportunity of serving as TP co-chair again for ICAS 2016. And you can imagine how excited and happy I am to be able to welcome you all here in Shanghai today. The organization of a huge international flagship conference like ICAS is by no means an easy task. This year in particular, we are working under severe time pressure, and you all know that. We have been pushing the program to March, which is unusual. Dominic and I are most grateful for all the support, assistance, and cooperation from all of you, authors, reviewers, contributors, volunteers, which I'm sure many of you make the success of these conferences possible. The dedication and tremendous effort of our TC chairs is instrumental in helping us to put up a high-quality technical program. We are also very pleased to see that many contributions coming from students and young researchers, they are definitely a strong pillar and also our future for the Signal Processing Society. May I now invite Dominic to give us a highlight of the many rich activities scheduled in the coming 4 days. Dominic, please.
Thank you, PC. So good morning, thank you for coming. Okay, all right. So we have prepared an exciting technical program for you. And as C said, this year we actually brought back the show and tell, and we also created a new activity of the student dialogue section. Now regarding the theme of the conference, it is Signal and Information Processing, the Heartbeat of a Smart Society. So we actually invited 5 very distinguished plenary speakers, and they will expand on the theme and share their research ideas and vision with us, and we are very grateful for that. Now, perhaps you wonder, wow, what is the acceptance rate for the conference? So it's actually 47% out of 2682 submissions. To maintain the quality, we actually make sure that each paper receives at least a minimum of 3 reviews. And the maximum number of reviews turns out to be 5, 6. It's actually 7. So it's a little bit exciting to be. And so you may wonder which TC actually able to find that many reviewers. Now regarding the distribution of the papers along different tracks, and this one we don't need to guess. The speech and language processing track remains to have the largest number of papers, and followed by the image, video, and multi-dimensional processing, and the signal processing theory and methods. So you probably know now, we actually need a visa coming to China. Nevertheless, United States remains to be the top country having the largest number of papers. The host country, China, is right behind, and then our friends from Europe, France, Germany, UK, and back to the Asian countries. So this is the session schedule for the remainder of the conference, except today there will be four technical sessions, three for papers, and one for plenary, which is at 11 a.m. For today, the plenary will be right after this opening ceremony, and we are going to have 7 oral and 10 poster sections in parallel, and we actually created the apps for you, so please check it out. Lastly, we have so many people to thank, and of course, including you. Without you doing high-quality research, deciding to submit your papers to ICAS, going through the visa application process to China, and finally coming a long way to attend, for sure ICAS 2016 will not be successful, and we are very thankful for that. So lastly, we hope our effort will be able to bring a smile on your face and some good feeling about ICAS 2016. Thank you, and please enjoy the conference.
Thank you, PC, and thank you, Dominique. So each year at ICAS, the president of the Signal Processing Society will address the audience to give the State of the Society address. So this year is no exception. So let's welcome Professor Rabab Ward to address the audience.
So this one is forward, and this is, and the lower band is back. Good morning, everyone. It's first of all, I want to thank Professors Wenjun Jiang and Tom Lo and Zi Deng. They are the chairs, and I want to thank all the organizing committee. Having organized ICASP in Vancouver just 3 years ago, I know the tremendous work, but pleasure as well, that comes with the job, so thank you very much. Before I also talk about the state of the society, I want to say how happy I am to be in Shanghai, in China. When I was a little girl in Lebanon, long time ago, China was like at the end of the world. And I always dreamt one day I will go there and explore all that rich history and culture and all what China had given to the world throughout centuries. And here I am. It's not my first time, but every time I come, it gives me more pleasure to be here. So I am here to talk about, this is where I, no, enter. I can't see what I'm seeing. So this is the state of the society. My name is Rabab Ward. I feel really great honor to be president of this fabulous society. It is not only honor, but I feel also a lot of happiness and pleasure to be serving as president and helping, because there's so many exciting things happening. It's just a wonderful society in every aspect. We are the fourth largest society in the IEEE, yet we are in many aspects the first per capita, especially in publications. So I'm supposed to talk about what's new and what's newish and what's happening. Well, a lot of fantastic and exciting things are happening. I will not be able to cover all of them in the 10, 15 minutes. I will just skip over, but this talk will be on the website, and everything will be on the website. So I will go over them one by one, and I will start with the visibility campaign. So the visibility campaign started almost over two years ago. And the idea is, we all know how important signal processing is. We all love it. We all know it is at the heart of every modern gadget or all sorts of instruments, and also now going to data and so many things. But yet when you are in a dinner party and you tell someone, they ask, what do you do? You say, we are in signal processing. And they look at you, if they are not in science, oh yeah, like, what is that? So we wanted everyone to know about what signal processing is. So we started the visibility campaign. Our aim, main target was high school and first or second year college students and professionals and the public at large. And we produced two videos. One is called What is Signal Processing? It shows to the public mainly what we do, and from it they can get a good idea. And then another video called Signal Processing and Machine Learning. Now these two, again aimed at the public in general, these two videos, we have translated them into Mandarin. I was hoping I'll have more time to show them, but we won't have time. And but hopefully maybe tomorrow or after tomorrow during one of the breaks, we will try to show them the Mandarin version. So I want to also urge you, all of you, to think about doing such videos. The SLTC, we are now doing a video in Bhuvana Rambandran has taken the lead, and we want every TC or whatever you think about doing videos. This young generation now really respond to videos a lot, much more than other media. And we have worked with a PR firm. We told them what we do, and we came out with the signal processing, the science behind our digital life. So we had a lot of discussions. Some people say we can't use the word science and so on, but it seems this is would be very much the best that we can go to the public at large. And we were told it's better to be 80% accurate and reach 20% of the people. It is better than being 100% accurate and reach only 20% of the people. What am I saying? Anyway, you get the idea that we want to reach the majority of the people. We also are, very soon, we will have a new fabulous revamped website, and we are doing multifaceted outreach effort, which will be starting after we finish with this website, which would be very soon, hopefully within 2 months you will see it. And we will be reaching to journals which are not only in science and engineering, but journals outside which the people read about science and engineering, to be able to make signal processing hopefully everybody will understand and appreciate. So I want to talk about our conferences very quickly. Next year we have ICASP in New Orleans. We have ICIP this year in the end of September in Arizona, and we'll have Global SIP in Washington, D.C. And please note under ICIP that next year it will be in Beijing in China. So this year we have ICASP. 7 minutes left. And we have in the past 3 years held a conference called China SIP in China, and we this year we are holding a VALS type of meeting in Wuhan, China, in April 2016. And this one is a meeting where there will be no paper submission, but it will be more invited talks and plenaries and posters and so on. So I invite everyone in China to attend this special meeting. We have technical directions. We have 2 years ago, we created what was called special interest groups. And this is to capture new emerging technologies. And we, so this SIG will be for, it will continue for 3 years, and then we decide at the end of 3 years whether or not we will continue it, or will it become a technical committee. We have three SIGs this year, one on big data, one on computational imaging, and one on the Internet of Things. The publications, this is a beauty. We are really more and more year by year. These are our seven main publications, which are totally owned, and run by our society. And altogether, this year, we have like 24,000 pages, which we have published. And they all have good impact factor and ranking. And besides these conferences, these seven, we are involved in many others, which we are financially co-sponsored or technically co-sponsored. We are involved in 21 other journals of the IEEE and four magazines, where we own a part, for example, like the IEEE transaction on multimedia and so many where we own part of it. So we are very strong. We are per capita number one in IEEE in the number of publications that we publish, and they are all very good quality. And this is another really beauty, is the changes in our membership. So the red color is the percentage change in the IEEE signal processing membership. You notice we are on the upward trend, especially towards the end, while the IEEE and the other societies, the average is way down. So this is just fabulous news, and I hope it will continue. And we are now the majority, like 40% in the US and in Canada, and in Europe and the Middle East, it's 27.6%. And in region 10, which is where we are, it's 28.7%. We have 176 chapters worldwide, and these chapters are very important for us. And we really urge every one of you, when you go back home, to be involved in the chapters. These are our grassroots of the society, and we really need to work with them. And you hear, many of you are leaders, we want you to be involved further. This year, we have 12 new chapters which were formed around the world, and we have 12 student branch chapters. And you might ask, what is a student branch chapter? If there is a chapter and there is group, there is a students in a university or a group of students in many universities, they can form a chapter, and we help them a little bit financially to do more great work. This year, the chapter of the year went to Gujarat chapter. This is really fantastic. We have very active chapters also in Region 10. As you see, Malaysia has got it twice as well, and Tainan and Europe. We have, for students, we have seasonal schools, and also for practicing engineers, and also for academics. And these seasonal schools have been a great success. And this year, so far, we have four. There will be more as the year goes on. I want to pay special attention to SIGView. SIGView is a library where we put our videos. It has fantastic tutorials, fantastic lectures, and you can go and put your lecture or your tutorial on SIGView. It's really, you don't need a professional. It helps you upload your own lecture. And SIGPort, which you have now heard about, you can put your presentations on SIGPort, and you can put theses, reports, draft manuscripts. As an example, in Global SIP 15, around 30% downloads of those presentations which were uploaded were downloaded within 30 days of the conference. For students, we have the student luncheon. This year is another big success. Actually, it's more than 170 students. They had to stop it at 190 students, where students and industry meet. We offer travel grants for students and others to come to our conferences. This year, we are again having the Women in Signal Processing Luncheon. And we have room still, because we booked a big room. And if you, men are welcome, by the way. It's not just us women. So, and it's tomorrow. And you are also welcome. We still have space, because the space takes 150 people. And we are so far only 112 have registered. The Signal Processing Cup competition, which is has been gaining more and more great success, and Jose will be talking a little bit further about it. This year we had 52 teams registered and 33 teams made it to the end. I'm gonna skip. We have three new society awards. They are all for targeted towards industry people and practicing in industry. And we have other new awards as well. And last but not least is your role as volunteer. We want you all to be involved in this great society. It's really exciting, it's really rewarding. And you can start with the chapters. Every one of us lives in a city. If you don't have a chapter, you can form a chapter. If you have a chapter, you can really go and make it stronger, and lot of networking, and know what industry and academia are doing. This is really important. Number two, you can, you must, please promise me, if you are not part of any TC or affiliate, today just go to the website. We have 10 technical committees, and you can just register to be a member of one of these technical committees, and then you can review paper, you can know what's happening in your area, and so on. And this is where you can find my talk. Last but not least, I am blessed with five fantastic men I'm working with. These are these people. They are all very, very dedicated and very intelligent and very hardworking and very smart. I want to thank them especially. And if you need anything, go to any one of these of us six people. I'm around. And thank you very, very, very much. Cheche.
Thank you, Rabab, for giving us an exciting snapshot of our society. So now the moment we have all been waiting for, the award ceremony. So let me welcome Professor Jose Mura, the chair of the awards board, to make the presentations.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues and friends. My name is Jose Mora, and I am the chair of the Signal Processing Society Awards Board. It's my great pleasure to attend the ICASP with you this week in Shanghai. General Chairs Zi Ding, Tom Luo, and Wen Junzhang and their team have assembled an excellent program in this beautiful city of Shanghai. I congratulate our president, Rabab Ward, for her state of the president of the society. Very nice. Today is my privilege to host the IEEE Signal Processing Society's award ceremonies and recognize many of our colleagues for their excellent work and achievements. And by the way, there are many, so just keep moving. With me on the stage today to help things go smoothly is the Society's President, Prabhab Ward, and Senior Manager for Operations, Teresa Argyropoulos. We have, as I mentioned, we do have quite a few awards to give, so we need to keep moving so we can meet our schedule. Before we start, a word of welcome to IEEE President Barry Shoup, who will present four IEEE Technical Achievement Awards to four of our SPSers colleagues. So that you know what's going to happen, the sequence is first Society Paper Awards, then Conference Paper Awards, then SPS Cup, then Society Awards, then the IEEE Technical Field Awards, and recognition, and finally the recognition of fellows. Did you get that? So let's get started. The first awards being presented today are the Society Best Paper Awards. This year, six are being presented, honoring the authors of papers of exceptional merit, dealing with topics related to the Society technical scope and appearing in one of the Society's transactions. The prize for all paper awards is $500 per author, up to a maximum of $1,500 per team of authors, and a certificate. And as I call your names, please come forward to receive your awards. Also, I would ask all the awardees to stay in the room at the end so that we can take pictures. The first award goes to Mark Davenport, Petrus Bufonus, and Michael Wakin and Richard Berenuk for their paper, Signal Processing with Compressive Measurements, published in the IEEE Journal of Selected Topics in Signal Processing in April 2010. Thank you. Our next paper award goes to Moshe Mishali and Yonina Elder for their paper, From Theory to Practice, Sub-Nyquist Sampling of Sparse Wideband Analog Signals, published in the IEEE Journal of Selected Topics in Signal Processing, April 2010. Our next award recognizes Xiao Yang Tan and Bill Triggs for their paper, Enhanced Local Texture Feature Sets for Face Recognition Under Difficult Lighting Conditions, published in the IEEE Transactions on Image Processing in June 2010. Our next award recognizes Thomas Pavney, Patrick Baz, and Jessica Friedrich for their paper, Steg Analysis by Subtractive Pixel Adjacency Matrix, in the IEEE Transactions on Information Forensics and Security in June 2010. Our next award recognizes Junil Choi, David Love, and Patrick Bidiger for their paper, Downlink Training Techniques for FDD Massive MIMO Systems, Open Loop and Closed Loop Training with Memory, published in the IEEE Journal of Selected Topics in Signal Processing in October 2014. The last Best Paper Award goes to Xunming Li, Shenyang Xu, Shang Feng Gui, and Martin Fox for their paper, Distance Regularized Level Set Evolution and Its Application to Image Segmentation, published in the IEEE Transactions on Image Processing in December 2010. The next award being presented is the IEEE Signal Processing Letters Best Paper Award, honoring the authors or authors of a letter article of exceptional merit and broad interest on the subject related to the Society's technical scope and appearing in the IEEE Signal Processing Letters. The award is being presented to Argirio Zimnis, Stephen Boyd, and Emmanuel Candes for their paper, Compressed Sensing with Quantized Measurements, published in the IEEE Signal Processing Letters in February 2010. The next award being presented is the Sustained Impact Paper Award, which honors the authors of a journal article of broad interest that has had sustained impact over many years on a subject related to the Society's technical scope. To be eligible for consideration, an article must have appeared in one of the IEEE Signal Processing Society transactions or the Journal of Selected Topics in an issue predating the Spring Awards Board meeting by at least 10 years. The recipients are Ingmar Cox and Joe Killian, F. Thompson Lighton, and Talal Shamoon for their paper Secure Spread Spectrum Watermarking for Multimedia, published in the IEEE Transactions on Image Processing, December 1997. I got it. The next award being presented is the Overview Paper Award, which honors the authors of a journal article of broad interest that has had substantial impact over several years on a subject related to the Society's technical scope. This year, the recipients are Beibei Wang and K.J. Ray Liu for their paper, Advances in Cognitive Radio Networks, a Survey. You guys are moving too fast for me. Okay, it's a great pleasure for the IEEE Signal Processing Society to celebrate young scientists, and we continue that trend this year in our next awards. The Young Author Best Paper Award honors the authors of an especially meritorious paper who is less than 30 years of age at the time of publication of the paper. This year, there are five such awards. Our first award goes to João Mota, for the paper co-authored with João Xavier, Pedro Aguiar, and Marcus Puschel, titled Distributed Basis Pursuit, published in the IEEE Transactions on Signal Processing in April 2012. Our next award goes to Dimitris Papaliopoulos, for the paper co-authored with Alexandros Dimakis, titled Interference Alignment as a Rank Constrained Rank Minimization, published in the IEEE Transactions on Signal Processing in August 2012. Oh, Dimitris could not be present. The next awardees are Jinning Han, Ankur Saxena, and Vinay Melkote, for the paper co-authored with Ken Rose, titled Jointly Optimized Spatial Prediction and Block Transform for Video and Image Coding, published in the IEEE Transactions on Image Processing in April 2012. The next award goes to Yua Xu for the paper co-authored with Jinlong Wang, Kiwi Wu, Alagan Ampalagan, and Yudong Yao, titled Opportunistic Spectrum Access in Cognitive Radio Networks, published in the IEEE Journal on Selected Topics in Signal Processing, April 2012. The next awardee is Peiren Song, for the paper co-authored with Gesualdo Scutari, Francisco Facinei, Daniel Falomar, and Zhongxi Peng, titled The Composition by Partial Linearization, Parallel Optimization of Multi-Agent Systems in the IEEE Transactions on Signal Processing, February 2014. So we move to the next type of award, and that's the IEEE Signal Processing Magazine Best Paper Award, honoring the authors of a paper of exceptional merit and broad interest on a subject related to the Society's technical scope appearing in the magazine. This year, we present the IEEE Signal Processing Magazine Best Paper Award to Tom Liu, Wing Kin Ma, Anthony Manchou Zhou, Yin-Yu Ye, and Xuzhong Zhang for their article, Semi-Definite Relaxation of Quadratic Optimization Problems in the IEEE Signal Processing Magazine in May 2010. So there is one more paper award, which is the IEEE Signal Processing Magazine Best Column Award, which honors the authors of a column of exceptional merit and broad interest on a subject related to the society technical scope and appearing in the society's magazine. We are proud to present the IEEE Signal Processing Magazine Best Column Award to Antonio Plaza, Javier Plaza, Abel Paz, and Sergio Sanchez for their article, Parallel Hyperspectral Image and Signal Processing, published in the magazine, volume 28, May 2011. None of the authors could be present. So this ends the paper awards, the Society Paper Awards. So I congratulate all of our paper award winners today. So next, I would like to announce the ICASP 2016 Best Student Paper Award winners and the Speech and Language Processing Student Paper Award winners. So the ICASP 2016 Best Student Paper Award is conferred to Shun Lin Liu from Caltech with the paper Super Nested Arrays, Sparse Arrays with Less Mutual Coupling Than Nested Arrays. And this award is sponsored by company Starkey, and we have company representative Tao Zhang to present the award. Do we have the, no? Okay. The next ICASP 2016 Best Student Paper Award is Zhao Jun Yang from the University of Southern California for his paper, Lightly Supervised Utterance Level Emotion Identification Using Latent Topic Modeling of Multimodal Words. And the company sponsor again is Starkey, and the Mr. Tao Zhang is presenting. Okay, we are back in sync. So the next paper, ICASP 2016 Best Student Paper Award, is Chen Chen and Yi Yan Han from the University of Maryland, College Park, for their paper, High Accuracy Indoor Localization, a Wi-Fi-based approach. The company sponsor again is Starkey, and Mr. Tao Zhang is presenting the award. So we now go to the ICASP 2016 Speech and Language Processing Student Paper Award. And we have three such. The first one goes to William Chan from Carnegie Mellon University, Listen, Attend, and Spell, a Neural Network for Large Vocabulary Conversational Speech Recognition. The company sponsor is iFlight Tech, and Mr. Ziguo Wang will give the award. The next ICASP 2016 Speech and Language Processing Student Paper Award is presented to Shun-Chi Liu from Johns Hopkins University, Hao Tang from Toyota Technological Institute at Chicago, to Vimal Manohar from Johns Hopkins University, to Rose Sloan from Yale University, and to Tyler Kekkonen University of Washington for the paper Adapting ASR for Under-Resourced Languages Using Mismatched Transcriptions. The company sponsor is IBM, and Dr. Michael Piccini will present the award.
cast for words.
Students?
Yeah.
Well, they are not in my... Okay. These two?
Yeah.
Okay, we go back to the paper awards. Sorry about the confusion. My script is not perfect. So we do have another ICAS 2016 student. So they are speech and language processing student paper awards, okay? Which one? Where are we? Okay. Another ICAS 2016 speech and language processing student paper award presented to Laurie Juvela from Aalto University, Baji Babu Bolpali from Aalto University, and Manu Airaksinen from Aalto University, high-pitched excitation generation for glottal vocoding in statistical parametric speech synthesis using a deep neural network. Again, the company sponsor is IBM, and the award is presented by Dr. Michael Pichini. Okay, next I'd like to announce the winners of this year's IEEE Signal Processing Cup. The Signal Processing Cup aims to provide undergraduate students with opportunities to form teams and work together to solve a challenging and interesting real-world problem using signal processing techniques. The Signal Processing Cup organizing team is led by Professor Min Wu from the University of Maryland. It's endorsed by the IFS Technical Committee and is overseen by the Signal Processing Society Student Service Committee, Patrizio Campisi, Chair. The 2016 Signal Processing Cup competition, Exploring Power Signatures for Location Forensics of Media Recordings, had the participation of 28 countries. And the grand prize, which consists of $5,000 plus travel grant support to ICASP, was presented to Team Resonance from Bangladesh University of Engineering and Technologies. As a nice tidbit, this team was present in the final three for every year since the Cup. The second prize win, with special recognition on originality, was presented to Tim Hammer down from Purdue University. And the third prize was presented to multi-universities, Tim Vidyut from India, IIT, M/NIT/IISC. And we thank the sponsors MathWorks for generously supporting the SP Cup. So we move now to the society's major awards. And the first is the Meritorious Service Award that recognizes dedication, effort, and contributions to the society. The award consists of a plaque and a certificate. And this year, the recipient is Min Wu from the University of Maryland. It's our pleasure to present you with the Meritorious Service Award for exemplary service to and leadership in the Signal Processing Society. Thank you. The next one is the Signal Processing Society Education Award that honors educators who have made pioneering and significant contributions to signal processing education based on a career of meritorious achievement in signal processing education, as exemplified by writing of scholarly books and texts, course materials, and papers on education. inspirational and innovative teaching, and creativity in the development of new curriculum methodology. The award comprised a plaque, a monetary award of $1,500, and a certificate. And this year, the Society recognized Ali Sayed for the writing of scholarly and influential texts in the area of adaptive systems and statistical signal processing. The purpose of IEEE and of the Society are technical, educational, and societal. It is no accident that the word technical comes first. The catalyst for the existence of the IEEE Signal Processing Society is the technology we all share as the basis of our careers, our efforts, and our achievements. Therefore, the IEEE Signal Processing Society Technical Achievement Award is of superior significance. The award comprised a prize of $1,500 per awardee, a plaque, and a certificate. This year, the Society recognizes the technical excellence of Li Deng. Is Li here? Okay, please come forward. For outstanding contributions to deep learning and to automatic speech recognition. So we have two new awards, and these are specially targeted to industry. The first award, for the first time this year, is the Industrial Innovation Award, which recognizes an individual or team at any level who were industry employees whose technical contributions have resulted in significant advances using signal processing technologies within the scope of the society. Selection is based on major industrial accomplishments, standards, deployment of important processes or products that are of substantial benefit to the public, which use signal processing technologies and are visible beyond the company or institution where the contribution was made. The award is open to individuals at any level who were industry employees who played a significant role in the technical contribution at the time of the accomplishments being recognized. The prize is $1,500 per awardee and a plaque and certificate. The recipient to receive the first Industrial Innovation Award is Gary Elko for outstanding contributions toward industrial research and commercialization of innovative electroacoustic devices and microphone array signal processing. Also awarded for the first time this year is the Industrial Leader Award, which recognizes an industry, business, or technical leader whose leadership has resulted in major and outstanding advances or new directions using signal processing technologies within the scope of the society. This award is for executive leadership resulting in major advances and new directions using signal processing in a business area. The prize is $1,500, the plaque, and the certificate. The recipient to receive the first Industrial Leader Award is John Treichler. He cannot be present. For sustained impact and leadership to the security and intelligence industry through signal processing innovations. John Treichler has graciously offered the monetary prize for the Industrial Leader Award to the Society's new Signal Processing Student and Young Professional Foundation Fund. The fund was created to support activities that encourage students and young professionals to participate in signal processing activities. You'll want to enjoy also this next award because it is the Society's most prestigious award, the IEEE Signal Processing Society Award honors outstanding technical contributions in a field within the scope of the society and outstanding leadership in that field. The award comprises a plaque, a certificate, and a monetary award of $2,500. It is my honor this year to present the Society Award to Alfred Hero for contributions to the field of statistical signal and image processing and for sustained service to the society. Okay, this ends the society level awards. We move to the another type of award. Our next award is the IEEE Signal Processing Society Chapter of the Year Award. The IEEE Signal Processing Society Chapter of the Year Award will be presented annually to a chapter that has provided their membership with the highest quality of programs, activities, and services. The award will be presented annually in conjunction with the International Conference on Acoustic Speech and Signal Processing, ICASP, to the chapter's representative. The award consists of a certificate and a check in the amount of $1,000 to support local chapter activities. The winning chapter will also be invited to publish an article in the IEEE Inside Signal Processing e-newsletter. The chapter to receive this award is the IEEE Signal Processing Society Gujarat chapter. The representative accepting the award is Shirak Panwala.
We did?
Yes, what page they came up in. Oh, came for the speech awards. Are you sure?
I don't have anything for these
You can see that we are at a loss. We just lost four awards. So I'll announce the awards and we'll give the check and we'll have to do it afterwards. But I'll announce them and we'll ask the awardees to come here. They will receive nothing except applause and a picture. So, the next one is the IEEE Ganesh Ramaswamy Memorial Student Grant. The Ganesh Ramaswamy Memorial Student Grant Fund is sponsored by IBM and honors the memory of the former member and IBM employee who died in 2008. Ramaswamy was manager of the Conversational Biometrics Group in the Human Language Technologies Department at the IBM Thomas J. Watson Research Center in Yorktown Heights, New York. He was a member of the IEEE Speech and Language Technical Committee. Candidates must be pursuing a degree at the university. The fund will support the recognition of an outstanding paper by a student in the technical area of speech or language recognition. The Ganesh Ramaswamy Memorial Fund is administered by the IEEE Foundation, and the prize should be presented by Dr. Michael Piccioni, who is present. And the award this year, the recipients are Shunlei Zhang from the University of Texas at Dallas, Shivesh Ranjan, the University of Texas at Dallas, Kian Zhang from the University of Texas at Dallas, Abhinav Misra from the University of Texas at Dallas, and Gang Liu, also from the University of Texas at Dallas. They are not here?
I guess. Is nobody here?
So none of them is here? Okay, so we'll move on to the next one. Oh, here is one. What? Is this a sign of IBM not giving up the checks? Okay, so let's move to the next one, for which also we don't have the checks, but they will be given, okay? The next students being recognized today are the recipients of the Spoken Language Processing Student Travel Grant. The grant is funded through the generosity of Shudong Huang, Alex Acero, and Chao Wen Hon, through the proceeds from their book that funds the grant. The basis of the grant award is the excellence of the paper submitted to ICASP and is provided to assist the student recipients in attending ICASP to present that paper in person. This year, the recipient is Eric Marchi from the Technische Universität of München and is presented by Xu Dong Huang. Thank you. So in case you are wondering, the Razwami and this award, they were decided only last night, and so there was no time to cut the checks. That's the thing. So, okay. So we are done with the society awards, papers, and major societies, and we move to the IEEE level technical field awards, and I will ask to come to the podium President Barry Shoup.
Thank you, Jose. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues. It is my true great honor and pleasure to be here with you today to present four technical field awards on behalf of the IEEE Board of Directors. The awards that we'll be giving here today are the most prestigious of the technical field awards, the IEEE James L. Flanagan Speech and Audio Processing Award, the IEEE Fourier Award for Signal Processing, the IEEE Leon K. Kirchmeier Graduate Teaching Award, and the IEEE Kyo Tomiyasu Award. The Flanagan Award is sponsored by the IEEE Signal Processing Society and recognizes outstanding contributions to the advancement of speech and or audio signal processing. This year, we are indeed fortunate to be able to honor IEEE and NTT Fellow, Dr. Takahiro Moriya, head of Moriya Research Lab in Kanagawa, Japan. And the citation is for contributions to speech and audio coding algorithms and standardization. For more than 30 years, if you look at who the trailblazers were in speech and audio coding research, you would consistently find one visionary, pioneering figure, Dr. Moriya. His inventions include transform coding with noise control based on the linear prediction coding spectral envelope, weighted interleave vector quantization, conjugate structure vector quantization schemes, moving average interframe prediction for spectral parameters, and the pitch synchronous processing for excitation signal of code excited linear prediction method. These inventions would have been exemplary in and of each of the individual ones by themselves. However, the impact of Dr. Moriya's work extends far past these innovations. His work has significantly contributed to the excellence of standards developed both globally and within Japan. His many inventions and innovations, as well as his efforts in coding standardization, have played a crucial role in the evolution of cellular telecommunications and will continue to do so far into the future. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating Dr. Moriya, recipient of the 2016 IEEE James L. Flanagan Speech and Audio Processing Award. Some minor technical difficulties, but we'll get around that. We will now present the IEEE Fourier Award for Signal Processing. This award is sponsored by the IEEE Signal Processing Society and the IEEE Circuits and Systems Society. The Fourier Award recognizes the outstanding contributions to the advancement of signal processing other than in the areas of speech and audio processing. This year, we are indeed fortunate to be able to honor IEEE Life Fellow Dr. Bede Liu, Professor of Electrical Engineering at Princeton University. The citation is for foundational contributions to the analysis, design, and implementation of digital signal processing systems. It's no exaggeration to say that today's world, one awash in videos and images captured digitally, would not have been possible without the vision, hard work, and remarkable skills and talents of Dr. Liu. In the field of digital signal processing, he has consistently been a pioneer. The development and ubiquity of the multimedia and mobile systems that are found everywhere today was only possible because of cost-effective, low-power signal processing systems. And those systems were only possible through the many vital technical contributions of Dr. Liu. His early innovative methods greatly reduced the number of transistors needed to implement the fast Fourier transforms and digital filters, two key operations in signal processing. Likewise, his efforts on signal processing error analysis streamlined application operations, also reducing the number of transistors needed to meet the requirements for application operations. Throughout a long and distinguished career, Dr. Liu has set a standard of excellence in commitment to his profession, his professional community, and to the future of digital signal processing. Among his former students are no less than 13 IEEE fellows, many of whom have gone on to lead the IEEE Signal Processing Society, as well as two members of the National Academy of Engineering. His work has not only improved our modern world, but set the stage for a bright and promising future as well. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the recipient of the 2016 IEEE Fourier Award for Signal Processing, Dr. Liu.
I'll be very brief. I received this award with gratitude and with humility because I know fully there are so many who have contributed so much to the signal processing field, starting from the Ardenhouse workshops until today in its glory. Most of what I did, most of what I have done, I did it with my students. Therefore, this award is as much a recognition of them as well. I also would like to thank Princeton University for providing the environment conducive to work. Now let me not forget to thank my wife, Maria, whose perspective, positive thinking, and outlook has a big influence on what I am doing. I also thank my daughter, Beatrice, who's here, and Charlie, my grandson. It's very special to see them here. Now let me thank the award board for this glove, for this honor. And finally, best wishes to all those who labor in the field of signal processing. Thank you.
So we have future generations of Signal Processing Society members in the audience today. Next award, we will now present the IEEE Leon K. Kirschmeyer Graduate Teaching Award. This award is sponsored by the Leon K. Kirschmeyer Memorial Fund and recognizes inspirational teaching of graduate students in the IEEE fields of interest. This year, we are particularly fortunate to be able to honor IEEE Fellow Dr. K.J. Ray Liu, the Christine Kim Eminent Professor of Information Technology at the University of Maryland at College Park. And the citation is for exemplary teaching and curricular development, inspirational mentoring of graduate students, and broad educational impact in signal processing and communications. Dr. Liu's students are taught to be creative and explore their ideas. They are taught to pursue excellence and to remember that industry will always hold them to a deadline and that there is a need to plan and act accordingly. It has been said that those who relentlessly pursue excellence find it, more often than not. Such is the case for Dr. Liu. Today, the University of Maryland's graduate program in communication and signal processing is globally respected. Each year, between 25 and 33% of graduate applicants to the electrical and computer engineering department choose to apply for signal processing. It is one of the most vibrant and well-regarded such graduate programs anywhere. And prior to 1990, it didn't exist. One of the key factors in building the graduate program in communications in signal processing was Dr. Liu. He developed from scratch two graduate courses that covered a broad, comprehensive syllabus of materials on the advanced theories and techniques of digital signal processing. He has published more than 10 books, authored more than 230 journal and 390 conference papers, many that included his students as co-authors. In addition to that, he has supervised more than 50 doctoral theses. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the 2016 recipient of the IEEE Leon K. Kirschmeyer Graduate Teaching Award, Dr. K.J. Ray Liu.
Thank you. It was a surprise. I didn't know I was a candidate until I received the announcements. I have been so fortunate to have so many outstanding young minds who came as graduate students, postdoc, and young colleagues to enrich my academic journeys. What I have been doing was just to pick up seemingly ugly milestones and keep polishing and crafting them for a few years until they reveal themselves as a gem and shine in their own way. That reminds me that I once myself an ugly stone, and that took many to craft and polish until I can stand up here. So I would like to dedicate to those who are polisher, crafter like me, who educate a new generation of engineers and scientists to make this world a better place. Thank you.
We will now present the IEEE Kyo Tomiyasu Award. This award is sponsored by Dr. Kyo Tomiyasu, the IEEE Geoscience and Remote Sensing Society, and the IEEE Microwave Theory and Technique Society. It recognizes outstanding early to mid-career contributions to technologies holding the promise of innovative applications. Today, we honor IEEE Fellow Dr. Yonina Eldar, a professor with the Technion Israel Institute of Technology in Haifa, Israel. Dr. Eldar is being recognized for the development of the theory and implementation of sub-Nyquist sampling for applications to radar, communications, and ultrasound. It would be difficult to overstate the potential impact of the work in sub-Nyquist sampling. At the present time, her work is finding potential applications across a vast array of fields in communications and signal processing. To date, Dr. Edlar has already demonstrated the possibilities of her work in cognitive radio, array processing, radar ultrasound, wireless communications, and a number of other areas. Her recognized work, she recognized that sub-Nyquist sampling could be utilized on signals that were sparse without distortion in the overall signal reconstruction. The X-sampling theory that she created allows for sampling of continuous time signals at rates that are orders of magnitude lower than the standard Nyquist rates. Most importantly, the signal is perfectly reconstructed from its samples, even if the undersampling structure of the signal is unknown. Dr. Eldar also built hardware prototypes to demonstrate how her innovations worked in real-time settings. The prototypes and patents that she developed have earned global interest in both academic and industrial applications. As a visionary engineer, wholly committed to advancing technology by now and far into the future, Dr. Eldar has exemplified what it means to be a giant in our profession. Her work has improved our world and will continue to do so for many years to come. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the recipient of this year's Tomiyasu Award, Yonina Eldar.
Okay, so I'm a little overtaken by the citation, but all right. So I'd like to thank my nominators and supporters, the award committee and its chair, and the entire community for this great honor. The signal processing community and the IEEE have been my home for the past 15 years, professionally and personally. Through ICASP and the IEEE Signal Processing Society, I had the opportunity to meet and learn from many people in this room, some of which have become my closest friends and colleagues. I would therefore like to thank my colleagues and collaborators in the audience who have enriched me both scientifically and personally, and whom I continuously learn from and are inspired by. Thank you very much for your warmth and encouragement and for believing in me. I've been extremely privileged to work with talented and creative students who have a large part in this award. We've done all of this together, and from whom I learned and continue to learn a great deal. I would therefore like to thank my entire research team that is kind of subsampled here in the audience. So for those of you here, thank you very much. This award is just as much yours as mine. Finally, a very deep thanks goes to my family in Israel for supporting my career, and to my husband, Shalomi, who is actually watching our 5 kids while I'm standing here talking, and that is not an easy job. So this award would really not be possible without them. Thank you very much.
And again, I'd like to thank you all. Thank you for the opportunity to be here today at such a vibrant conference.
Thank you, Barry. So before we announce the fellows and recognize the fellows, I'd like to recognize the Kilby Award, Jack S. Kilby Signal Processing Medal. So that's an IEEE level medal, IEEE level award, but it's IEEE holds an award ceremony in June in New York City. It's, if I'm correct, at Astoria Waldorf Hotel, right? And President Barry Shoup will present the medal to the Kilby winner. However, it's a tradition that here at ICASP, we recognize the signal processor that is the award winner of the Kilby medal. And so it's with great pleasure that I present to you the recipient of the 2016 IEEE Jack S. Kilby Signal Processing Medal, Louis Scharf, for pioneering and sustained contributions to statistical signal processing and its practice. So,
thank
Well, this gives me an opportunity to thank friends, family, mentors, students, and colleagues who actually have allowed me for 50 years to play with them while pretending to work. It's been my entire professional career has been spent in this society, and I thank all my collaborators for their generous patience while we tried to get to the bottom of kind of vexing questions. I have one request of all of you, and that is during a break, open your browser, Google Jack S. Kilby's Nobel Laureate speech, and you'll learn something about the doggedness and the humility of this great man who built the first monolithic integrated circuit and then contributed very substantially to the development of the chip technology. So watch his Nobel speech. It's not a riveting public speech, but it reveals a man with real dedication to purpose. And then if you see someone from Texas Instruments here, thank them for endowing this Jack S. Kilby Medal Award in 1995. Thank you very much.
Okay, now we move to the to recognize the fellows, the SPS members that were elevated to IEEE Fellow as of January 1, 2016. In 2016, IEEE elevated 52 Signal Processing Society members to Fellow. Their pictures might have been shown at the beginning of this award ceremony. And I say might because I didn't look at the screen at the time. But we will recall here those of the 52 SPSers elevated to fellow that are in the audience. And as we call you, please come forward and join us at the podium here. And to the audience, please hold your applause until all names are announced. So the first one is Kiyowaru Aizawa from Tokyo, Japan, for contributions to model-based coding and multimedia life logging. The second one is Frederic Dufour from Paris, France, for contributions to visual information processing and coding. The next one is Larry Heck from Mountain View, California, for leadership in application of machine learning to spoken and text language processing. Next one is Wendy Rabiner Heinzelman, Rochester, New York, for contributions to algorithms, protocols, and architectures for wireless sensor and mobile networks. Next one is Jivu Huang from Shenzhen, China, for contributions to multimedia data hiding and forensics. Next is Itoshi Kiya from Tokyo, Japan, for contributions to filter structure, data hiding, and multimedia security. Next one is Eric Larsson from Linköping, Sweden, for contributions to the technology of multi-antenna wireless communications. Next is Ta-Sung Lee from Hsinchu, Taiwan, for leadership and contributions in communication systems and signal processing. The next is Wai-Zi Lin from Singapore, for contributions to perceptual modeling and processing of visual signals. Next one is Falong Luo, San Jose, California, for contributions to adaptive signal processing for hearing and multimedia applications. The next one is Satoshi Nakamura from Ikoma, Nara, Japan, for contributions to speech recognition and speech-to-speech translation. The next is Zhong Feng Wang from Irvine, California, for contributions to VLSI design and implementation of forward error correction coding. The next is Shen Yang Shu from Berkeley, California, for contributions to medical imaging and image-guided interventions. The next is Bing Zeng from Chengdu, China, for contributions to image and video coding. Congratulations to all of you on your extraordinary achievements. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, that concludes today's ceremonies. I want to thank all of you for attending and celebrating the IEEE Signal Processing Society's award. And we should congratulate all recipients and the new IEEE fellows. The Society holds its award ceremonies annually in conjunction with ICASP. I look forward to meeting you again at next year's ceremony. I must say that the I here is really not true because someone else will be holding this place next year. Thank you very much for attending.
1 minute for you. Thank you, Professor Jose Mura. And congratulations again to all the award recipients and also the fellows. So this concludes the opening ceremony. And we will reconvene at 10:20 for the first plenary talk. I promise this is going to be a spectacular show. So stay tuned to join us.